Welcome, my YouTube crew and Twitch crew. Now I got both. And I got a new dual audio mixer, but I also need a new separate mic, so that's the unfortunate thing. So there might be sound interference, but I got a minute 24 to MK11. I got to try out the demo. I was mildly happy with Cabal. Not too sure about Jade or Scarlet. I like them, but they're a little weird. I'm curious how Liu Kang is going to move in this. I got a minute and 7 seconds. I'm just super hyped. So I won't be doing my fatality for this. Not fatality. I won't be doing story mode. I already want a fatality. You can tell I have it in me. I've only spoiled the one fatality in each trailer, by the way. And the second Johnny Cage one, which was also in another trailer. I am not going to do story right now for this video, so story will be in the next video. But this will just be like an initial impression slash tutorial, because I want to know what the hell I'm going to be doing in 40 seconds. Oh, get hype! Hype is real. I can't be any more ready for this, man. I am ready. I hope the sound quality's okay. Sorry if it's a pain in the ear. Oh, 20 seconds. I don't know what to say. I've been playing MK since I was wee old baby. Got scared by JX's original OG fatality. Hope they do a... And I know that Cetrion, I think, is a new one. Did that a play on that. Okay, here we go, here we go. 2, 1, let's go. Yeah, it did. Did it not? Installing add-on. Oh, I got Shao Kahn. Alright. Okay, that scared me. I was like, premium edition skin. It must have been for like pre-order. Let's do this, guys. I got simultaneously worried there for a second. Oh my god. I'll be fine for that, but YouTube crew, watch out. This is going on both Twitch and YouTube. Both of them are under the same name, ABSKEPiC. Let's have fun. Also gotta watch the intro if there is one. Doesn't seem like there's an intro. Let's go. Oh, I just want to go right at the story. I accept. I don't need to read the terms of service. Right when the Red Dragon Lozo is barely visible, so I probably... Only the Red Dragon Lozo. Let's go. Let's make that. Actually, I'll put that on. Alright, conquer, fight, customize, learn. I want to go to the Crip and Sea Shang Tsung, but what can I customize here? Unable to sync your online inventory of the MK11 server innovation changes. Temporary improvement. I want part of the store. Okay, so whatever I'm gonna do is not totally permanent. So let's just learn. Practice tutorial, fatality training. Let's just do tutorial. A lot of errors on the first day. There's quite a bit of tutorial to go through too. I figure too early? Maybe the whole thing's not up until 12 o'clock? I'm a bit early, but I'm in. Two. enough like how to execute short hop properly. Never picked that one up.
Grab it if you're grabbing too much shit. Okay, I'm starting to like this a little better.
That's enlightening about the defensive gauge, though. Get over here.
Yeah. I think I'll just make this a tutorial then and I'll start story.
Pain.
Let's close this and let's see if I can re-enter and do the same. I hit the dojo. I just want to go to the crypt. And meet Shang Tsung.
Your soul is mine.
Load. That's a weird start. Oh, I get it. Okay, let's see. Fight, customize, conquer. I don't think anybody can get in. Tutorials here, but it's good to know all this information early, even though I know some of it and lots of it transferred over. Better to know now.
banging though.
This is what I want. And trust me, I'm about to humiliate myself on defense when we get to that section. I still find it interesting that some escapes are require the defensive gauge. So, briefly tap up instead of holding up. Section. So it's just a light tap. That's gonna be. I'm glad the D-pad is very new, so that's good, but I'm not gonna like that on arcade stick. Shit, this is useful. If a second attack is blocked and the character is low on health, they will be on the last breath. The character will lose access to the rest of the defensive gauge. And can now be defeated with block damage. That's so freaking useful. I like the system way better than what Street Fighter has. And their defensive gauge just goes. Oh my god. So you can get projectiled out. Pretty damn crazy.
Oh.
System. It's a conditional system. And it looks like when I woke up the one time, I lost a bit of defensive gauge too. You know how many people could learn so much from just this frame data tutorial? Like, don't get a pro to explain it. The game should explain it. I'm glad this game is taking a step to do it. Street Fighter had it really good with the mode, and you could see like the blue and the red, but I actually really like this. Safe attacks, unsafe attacks, punishing. Oh, that's great. Honestly, like, I played fighting games for a long time, and I never knew that stuff until like about a couple years back, actually. And I kind of wish games taught you that as you went, if there was like a non-mandatory tutorial. Okay, reversal attacks, doesn't matter. Shoutouts to all my fans. Just kidding. I hope to make MK a regular occurrence on Twitch. Into what moves are really, really fast, because we used a special move for that. Raiden looks like he has a universal one, which is pretty nice. Get up. Attacks cost half your offensive and defensive gauge. Picks two. Oh, that's not good. Negative attack can be risky as you're vulnerable if you miss the opponent's block. Instead of attacking, you spend every defensive game from the opponent's get up roll. Okay, I see the get up roll. Help you. Oh, I don't like using L2. A forward get a broken switch sides to the opponent if they're affected in your corner. Flawless block. And I do hope this helps people. Like, granted, I'm the one performing it, but this seems like a really, really good tutorial that extends past just this game. A lot of little things going into this game that I really, really like. A few small ones going to go reach. For like a minute. That's fast. That's really damn fast. So risky! I'm starting to get this game and how it plays. This is nuts! Yeah. Who knows when the servers are going up, but probably 2 hours. I'm not going to be able to do it by tonight anyways, but... Gonna be a long video, man. Probably about an hour. Lost all the defensive game. Oh, that's a risky. And you're still on the ground when you're wet, so. All of your game just in one breakaway, but that could stop the most harmful combo, or it could be baited. God, MK wanted your actions to have consequences. Are we getting coins now? 10 times, just for sure. Yo, read the crypt. Let's check out the crypt. I'm gonna do frame data right after this, but I just got it. It's the crypt. Oh, Come on, NetherRealm. Oh, shoot. You can buy some stuff with some... So this is probably the most interesting section that I was alluding to earlier. If you ever have any trouble in any game, you should probably go to this tutorial. This applies to Smash, Street Fighter, Killer Instinct, anything that has an attack. Even simpler games. Okay, so when they say beginning, middle, and end, they say startup. Startup is pretty much at the beginning of your punch. Middle is the active frame, and the end is the plus or minus at the end of the frame it takes for you to recover back to neutral. Sixty frames in 1 second. Beginning attack known as startup describes the amount of time in frame before attacking with the opponent. Perform 3 attacks out of the fast out of time. Start a portion of each attack will be harder than you do. So, you got blue? That's the startup. The moment I leave the blue, it's an attack. So, I get orange. During blue, I am blocking. That is 7 frames. That is a little bit slow by 2 frames. So, this takes 27 frames, but it's an overhead. So that's about 1/3 of a second. Actually, almost half a second. This is 1/3. And this is almost half a second. The middle of an attack is known as aftertake. It starts with 3 at a time, and then the attack is the same. Perform 3 attacks at a short active time. The aftertake will use attack at a time of the event. So you see that blink there? That's the only one that has this option. So at any point I'm not red. And I start up and I'm hitting. So that's a very, very short time. Three frames is pretty damn good too. And 4.1 frames is down there. Attack mode recovery, in which the attack can move to the opponent, but the character plays after the turn's in neutral. So these are very fast. These are whiffs, by the way. So the green is auto whiff. That green portion is when you're about to whiff. So it's right after the whiff. So these are unsafe as well. Unsafe. See that long green period? That's not good. You're risking not having a long sword. The time it took to actually put up that sword is longer. Hit advantage. Okay, this could be really, really good. Hit advantage is like safe attacks, pretty much. So, advantage and disadvantage. Some attacks are punishable. Some are very hard to punish. You need very quick attacks to punish the ones that are really safe ones. For example, if you hit an opponent with an attack that is a hit by the 9 frames, you can move 9 frames before the opponent can. That's so good. So that's plus 9. From the following attack with high hitting damage. And observe how much earlier you recover before the opponent plays. Recovery of the faster track will be highlighted in blue. Has 9 frames on hit. So I should probably connect it to something else. Having advantage of the hit the real hand for a short time as it freed with attack while your opponent can only wait in the rock. So this is on hit again. So fine. So that's super on hit though, not on block. So if you're hitting him, you can probably connect with him. Attacks that knock down the opponent will be used to get him clear at the higher hit again. The attacks that leave the opponent down on hit. See how much time I have? Look how far it puts him, so I'm going to run up, block, or run up and down, but they're on knockdown behind, so they're going to be good. I'd love this tutorial, we're doing something to be good. Tutorial's great. This is probably the best tutorial I've ever gone through. So this is just block advantage. So both of the following types have high block advantage, but they're 130 recovery from the opponent. So these are plus 3. So the time I can block saves a little. The last hit of this combo has 7 frames. See how far it pushed her? And I can block in time before she could do the attack like that. The attack has a block attack at 0, both characters recover at the same time. This is not a good use for them at all. So this attack will go at the same time. Or it's a gamble at that point. So these are minus attacks. These are the really unsafe ones that are combo starters. But you see how fast? Like I'm gonna have an orange. That's not good. 20 frames, so your overhead, which is slow. Oops. Oh, this is teleport. Yeah, that has highly punishable. You probably don't do that. So it's disappointing that if you're minus. Not good on minus. Very good on plus. Ah, the unsafers. High risk, high reward. A lot of the old MK attacks were unsafe. Sometimes you could bait opponents into attacks into doing something full screen, like the Liu Kang kick, or the Liu Kang bicycle kick was the most unsafe move. Could have blocked any of your attacks and you're able to hit you with the attack. The attack is unsafe on block. So there's nothing I could have done. A skilled opponent was able to consistently punish you with a counter attack or a blocking attack was unsafe. You can tell if the attack is able to block that high block disadvantage. And the opponent's attacks with fast enough startup time will be able to hit you with block attack. So they gotta have more startup time for this. So if I hit him with this circle attack here, he has 17 frames to act. See? So I'm going to wait to see if he's cracking their luckily to block. Or for a jumping opponent, but committed to like that. So, high risk, high reward. Okay. Safe attack. So, these are the ones you want to end combos with, possibly start pressure strings. One of the best examples of someone being safe is Tanya MKX, because, Evo 20. 16, I think? Tanya happened? Yeah, that's a lot of robots getting used. Attacks can be safe on block when it has been blocked. The opponent has no attack before you recover. See how safe it is? An attack that was. Block advantage of 0 more likely than safe on block. So. Some attacks that block super strength could still be safe on block. If I don't recover quickly, you block, you have enough time to block any damage. Still start up a block disadvantage. Sub-Zero sweep has a blocker damage of minus 4, so not so good. Potato doesn't have any attacks that have the start of a max 4 frame. So Zero always deals a blocker. I'll follow up attack on Potato. So I'm safe regardless. Better to use attack for the safe on block, you don't have a good chance of blocking. Be aware that the attack safe on block can still be risky if you miss a fire loop, especially with a block of cover. So let's see this combo here. Oops. Some attacks have different block advantage depending on the distance. I will hear from the block the attack and send it back to the safe on block at one distance and unsafe at a different block. So close range, but farther. I love this tutorial so much. Punishing. Punishment as a counterattack like a hit, and a safe attack as a recovery to block punishment as a block by the recovering character. Generally attacks longer recovery, not blocking the punishment attack with long setup. Start a punishment attack, less than block damage, and the child could counterattack and successfully punish an unsafe punish appears on the side. Attack with fast startup. Check that can also start combos off and with a death attack in front of your opponent. A punish with one of your best options you can do is significant damage to your opponent to make the most. Spacing when punishing attacks on your opponent's unsafe attack can be farther back on the block. Out of your reach is fast. If that's like that scorpion punish. Your spacing can attack with longer range. Punish attack with a basic attack at the start of it barely fast enough for the unsafe. A reversal attack can make punishing in some situations, so it always has a very first frame of recovery. A little better, but they're not combo starters, so they don't want to spend gauge. This is probably the best tutorial I've ever played in terms of learning the game and whatnot, how easy it's put. It's a lot better than their Justice tutorial. I'm going to see my YouTube crew later and my Twitch crew later. I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'm going to be uploading and doing the entire story mode. Hope, potentially in one sitting. I'm going to go with a fatality and demonetize myself. And I'm going to pick one that I haven't seen before. Oh, Liu Kang looks badass. Katana, Kung Lao, Jackie's. I've seen most of these, but. Purchase Frost? Hell no, I'm unlocking it. Cybot, Cabal, Kano, Scorpion, Kang, Katana, Raiden. Let's do Cetrion.
Cetrion. Yeah. Sub-Zero. Shinnok's Bone Temple.
Crisp, though. Game's looking damn good, though. I'm gonna finish it off with the thing I started with.
Finish him!
Easy fatalities. Yeah, I'm just gonna look this up real quick. Move list, special moves. I haven't seen the good and evil fatality yet, so once it's actually locked. MK11 fatality inputs. I regret looking this up, but at a glance, let's see. Come on, don't do that to me. Cetrion. Back down, back three. One, two. Let's do this. Oh, wait, this is the first one. That's not what I wanted. Demonetized. I want to go back to that.
Cetrion wins. Flawless victory.
Yeah, flawless. Free try. I never did the maintaining balance one then. Should have just done the original one. I didn't know that was the other one.
Finish him.
I've never seen this one. Okay, there's a couple
fatality
things going on there.
Cetrion wins.
Oh,
flawless
God. I
victory.
Felt like the three references put into one. The one where Peter Griffin is getting the fire hose, and then it's followed by what happens to be like the fire with the T-Rex and the little legs and whatnot, or the little arms, and followed by the Freddy Krueger slash. That's definitely what that was. I will see you guys later.